Is me or goddess? Oh, okay, yeah. So, goddess, you have been challenged to a best of five set. It has begun. Once the set finishes up, you guys can get back to your regularly scheduled lobby. I do apologize if you were in the chat and I kicked you from the lobby, but this rule, this 1v1 rule outshines a lot of things. This is priority. That was a great edge guard. He can still keep the edge guard going if he wants to. Good tech. Now back in the range with Minmin is very dominant, but projectiles are really strong. Gyro's out on the field. Without the use of gyro, Rob is kind of weaker. Only slightly. Alright, there we go. Goddess got her hands on it. Stock was taken. Got a good old megabot forward air. I can never tell if it's a forward or back air because they all look the fucking same. But now the bigger problem. Oh no, wait. She has special moves to also do that. But Rob got that spin to win on deck, so you know that's an easy stock to take. But now here's the problem. Being mid range against Minmin, if you're not using projectiles to keep her walled out, then, well, if you're not using projectiles to disrupt Minmin, then you'll have a problem in general. That was some interesting item play. It's evened up. All right, let's go. We got a real match on our hands right now. Ooh! 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 Game one with dominance on that stop. With the dominance on that stop. That was a great. That was a fantastic edgeguard with gyro. Game two, we're on battlefield this time. The platforms can be used to either player's advantage. Yeah, that's a stock. Turtle is not playing no games. He wants to prove himself. Ah, he's gonna make that back. Out of gas and the juice. Double hitbox on Dare. Minmin's Dare has two hitboxes. It's not like Sonic's there. Goddess is playing very grounded right now, just focusing on being closer to the floor instead of trying to go for aerial edge guards. But because of that, it's allowing Turtle to recover somewhat freely. Oh! Two frame! It may or may have not been the two frame, but either way, it was a fantastic edge guard. Spin to win! Gyro was there, so there had to be a lot of patience. Because Dara went too far, it wasn't able to SR properly. Oh! Evened up! Goddess is playing to their advantage right now by staying mid-stage and being mostly grounded. But Rob can maul through shields if you're not careful. Megawatt is on deck along with Sparky's, why are you playing these games with me? So we got 1-1 on the board right now. Gyro gimps are real. Game 3. Let's see who takes this. What saves are we blessed with as well? We're on FD, so no platforms this time around. And plus we got that good old Persona music playing right now too. Up, down tilts? Turtle's really pressing that advantage. Turtle's really good at pressing advantage as well. I will give him that. And I've seen Goddess edgeguard pretty solidly most of the time. I think we all witnessed that on the stream as well. That's a free gyro opportunity. But Dragon was out there too. Oh! Gyro gimps. Tether recoveries are kind of eaten up by gyros. Wow! Turtle! Someone please clip that for him. That was beautiful. I'm not going to even front. Somebody clip that. Finish him! This fight so far has literally been a contest of anything you can do, I can do better. I love it. Convincing win there. Score is now 2-1 in favor of Turtle. Now we're on game 4. Now we're on Pokemon Stadium. So this platform is back. The roof is definitely smaller though, so up smashes can kill pretty early for Rob, as well as up airs. But But it also doesn't help that gyro is a thing that can keep fucking up the recovery from him. And because it's getting stale, then it's not gonna be easy to kill with. Ooh, a megawatt nair. I would like to say that Mim is probably only in this game because of the other arms guy is not. That was beautiful. If you would have got the follow-up, that would have been it. But good patience, that allows for the up smash to come out. I know I'm presented for the commentator's curse as well, because I did say that there is two hits. And the patience was heavily rewarded. Trapping in the middle of the stage. Megawatt on deck. Like I said, up smash kills very early for a lot of people now. So next thing you have to watch out for is Megawatt. Because Megawatt Nair is very deadly. And then with Dragon as well. But more than likely, Turtle can take the stock back because the gyro gets. That was good patience on the up smash. And that was a good laser to avoid the initial. Oh, Megawatt is on deck again. Megawatt Nairs are very scary. And so are Dragon Edgeguards. Parried the first hit, but did not get the second hit off. I'll say so. Oh! Sniped! And then the return fire. Goddess wants to take this to game 5. Oh yeah, we going to game 5, y'all. Let's get it. We have ourselves a real match. Just remember, if you are in the chat and you just got here, please sit on the bench first. This is a best of 5. This is game 5 coming up right now. Alright y'all, let's get it popping. Game 5. Game 5, I unfortunately missed out on a lot of commentary because I was doing some matters for the Discord. If you guys have problems... Oh! That was a good read. If you guys have problems getting into the Discord or activating any channels, let me know immediately so I can fix that. Game 5, both of you guys look like you really want that win. Ooh! Right at the jump. Ah! There it is. A little bit impatient for that. Now, this is a real match. Final stock. Will it end again with the gyro gimps, or are we about to see some wild shit? Let's find out. Let's use against Min Min. Now, both are in a dangerous game. Oh, good set. Round of applause to both of these competitors. Round of applause. Good games. Question, do you guys want me to upload this to YouTube? So that way you guys can see it and then play each other? Now that the set is over as well, everyone can hop back in the lobby.